Welcome back. You're watching Headlines Now. In this fast-growing and competitive world, it's important to have a healthy mind and a healthy body. And doctors say awareness will help in treating and preventing mental problems that seem to be catching many people unaware. To mark World Mental Health Day today, our reporter Kuku Alex visited the Institute of Mental Health to find out what the experts had to say. Let's listen in.
Have you ever had that splitting headache before the start of an exam? Or that sudden loss of appetite at the start of a very important day? Well, that's your body telling you something is not right. That's the message that the doctors at the Institute of Mental Health have for us today.
Physical health can affect the mental health of the individual, and the mental health can affect the physical health also. It's very, very difficult to identify, diagnose. The symptoms are not actually accepted as depression by the patient. I'm not depressed, but they'll complain about all these things.
Experts say early detection is the key to identifying chronic mental problems. But is that enough? What comes after the doctor's prescription and the nurse's medicines? The need of the hour is awareness that mental illness is quite common. About 450 million people the world over are affected by conditions like anxiety, depression and phobias.
So we are highlighting to the public that they should take care of themselves physically to avoid such chronic illnesses. We conduct more than 14,000 camps we have conducted in the past 3 years in Tamil Nadu.
A sound mind in a sound body need not be just a motto. Doctors at the IMH say the next time you have a physical ailment, consider your mental state as well. In Chennai, with Kuku Alex, Evelyn Matthew for NDTV Hindu.
Well, for more on that, we have with us Dr. Abhilasha, a psychologist and also president of the Arudal Charitable Trust, a trust which has been formed to make sure that such comments don't increase. But you are saying, psychologists like yourself are saying, that it's become somewhat of a common problem. What exactly do you mean? What kind of problems? And is it the lifestyle?
Of course, it is the lifestyle, because nowadays people face a lot of stressors at workplace, in family, in financial crisis, everywhere. So I think these factors, plus the nuclear family pattern, and all these are forcing them to face more of stressors, which will lead them to depression and frustration, and from there on to suicidal ideation.
And you're saying these things are increasingly becoming a common problem among people, yeah?
Definitely, because one out of four people are getting affected with depression or anxiety, okay. The whole world.
Okay, now you have started this trust, this Arudal Charitable Trust. I mean, if you can tell us why. Why you have started this? What is it that led to this idea?
Yes, the trigger which made us to start the trust was that the Lancet, British journal, you must be knowing, has come out with this. The highest number of suicide rates among youngsters is in South India.
And that you're talking world over?
World over.
Okay, that's
so this
interesting.
This was really shocking and very painful, in fact. So we thought we have to do something for the society. So we have started the trust. And the three objectives we are looking at is to prevent suicide, to reduce crime rate, and also to reduce family conflicts through psychological approach.
Okay, these three, based on what have you actually arrived at, saying these are the three main issues you want to look at? And how exactly are you looking at dealing with this?
The two things I want to specify here is, number one, we have to strengthen the awareness and weaken the stigmas. This is very important because people are not coming out, they are not taking this as a simple common cold or anything. People are afraid to approach a psychologist because they will be labeled as a mental or a psycho or whatever. So that has to be broken, and it's for your goodness that you're coming out and reaching to a psychologist. So be open to it. And the second thing, please be aware that we are available and don't have any stigmas attached to
it. How can people reach you if they have to?
Yes, if anyone's having suicidal ideation or any sort of psychological problems, you can reach us at 99620445569. This is our helpline number, as well as you can reach at www.arudhal.in. Actually, we named it Arudal because we want to give consoling to people.
All right, Doctor, thanks a lot for joining us. We hope that there is more awareness among people.
I also want to thank NDTV for helping us spread the awareness.
Thanks a lot, Doctor, for joining us, Dr. Abhilasha. So, time to take a quick break after that very interesting discussion. Moving on, the Master Blaster gives his fans more to cheer for. I will tell you what on the other side.